Dr. Cindy Trim is at it again. This time she is speaking at a women's conference hosted by Bishop T.D. Jakes. Here she unfolds her wild, unbiblical, and unfounded revelations at the Woman Thou Art Loose conference being held in the month of October. Dr. Cindy Trim took her message from the book of Judges, where she spoke about Deborah being the fourth judge over Israel. She told the women that they should desire the spirit of Deborah, for she was a great female judge who had it going on. Dr. Cindy Trim said Deborah came from the tribe of Ephraim, and each tribe had their own month. She then flashed a Baphomet sign. She said Deborah's month was the month of October. This news of Deborah made the women scream with glee, joy, and unfortunately, no knowledge. Why, Dr. Cindy Trim stroked in their heads the month of October. Manipulating the women into feeling like they, too, had something in common with Deborah because of the conference being held in the month of October, in the same month of Deborah, according to Dr. Cindy Trim. Here is the video.
Each tribe had a month, and her month was the month of October. October is the month of the letter rain.
Yes, Deborah was the fourth judge in Israel, and yes, she came from the tribe of Ephraim. But the month of October myth is false doctrine and cannot be supported by the word of Yah. It is nothing more than numerology and astrology, both deeply rooted in the occult. Dr. Cindy Trim knows this, but wanted to push her diabolical October agenda, lying about Deborah's association with the month of October. This she did in order for the women to embrace the month of October as something very significant. And if you think this conference held in the month of October is just happen chance, please think again. Many Women Thou Art Loose conferences have held its meetings in the month of October, such as with 2010, 2011, and 2012. Dr. Cindy Trim said the month of October is very, very special. Even the movie Woman Thou Art Loose became a box office top hit, coming out in the very month of October 2004. The month of October is known as Satan's Harvest Celebration for Satanists. His followers prepare for Satan's harvest of souls during the complete month of October. Their diabolical activities build the entire month of October and climax on October the 31st, Halloween, which is dedicated to a planned worldwide human sacrifice. Dr. Cindy Trim said October is the month of the latter rain. She said it is time for you to reap your harvest. She is covertly making reference to the Rain Man, Satan. This term is often used in hip-hop music and other genres. Here is the video.
October is the month of the latter rain. It is time for you to reap your harvest.
Yes, it's harvest time, all right, for Cindy, Jakes, and Satan. It's a trick on the women and a treat for them. Allow me to show you the double-wide diabolical bed that both Dr. Cindy Trim and Bishop T.D. Jakes sleep and play in. Pay close attention to the 2010 Women Thou Art Loose ticket sold for the month of October. Do you see anything out of place? Pay close attention to the 2011 Women Thou Art Loose ticket sold for the month of October. Do you see anything out of place? Pay close attention to the 2012 Women Thou Art Loose ticket sold for the month of October. Do you see anything out of place here? Do you see it yet? These wicked images are an attack on the subconscious mind. It is designed not to be seen with the conscious mind. The ticket size being small, no doubt concealed the wicked image from your conscious mind, but your subconscious mind swallowed it up whole. Remember, we are ran predominantly by the subconscious mind and not the conscious mind. As high as 90% of what we do and perceive comes from the subconscious mind. Subliminal suggestions and backward masking techniques are all caught and perceived on this level, the subconscious level, bypassing the conscious mind and becoming a stronghold with the subconscious mind. This is why Satan targets this part of your mind to attack using crafty techniques such as subliminal suggestions and backward masking, bypassing the conscious mind altogether. This is why advertisement targets this part of your mind to attack, because they know the power of subliminal suggestions and are willing to spend millions on it each and every year. Subliminal suggestions are often found in music. It is called backward masking. In secular music, many times when a producer or artist want to get across a not-so-desirable message to the masses, they throw a fastball. They will implant the message into the music by using a backward masking technique, allowing subliminal suggestions, in which the message could be heard subconsciously or if the music were to be played backwards. Subliminal images are also just as effective on the subconscious mind, and so they are highly used in abundance. Warning. Some of the following subliminal images are extremely graphic and could be considered quite offensive, but for the sake of opening up one's eyes to the cunning craftiness of the enemy, it is necessary. They are there to sell you food. Notice the dollar bill placed in the lettuce. Notice the small erection on the male character. The image has been magnified for you to see. This kid's movie is called The Little Mermaid. They are hidden in cartoons like The Lion King. Subliminal suggestions are often used to sell technology. Here we have the Kool-Aid Man, with two eyes made of two sixes and one nose made of one six, and the number 666 appears on the happy face. Here we have three green beer bottles that give the image of a male's bottom, two legs, and a male's sex organ upside down. Here we have a bakery advertising their bread in a procreative design. This woman is clicking a pink mouse against a pink background, but we can all see what it clearly looks like. This is a floor company advertising for business, but turn the picture upside down and it looks like she's taking care of business. Who would have known a pair of fallopian tubes would sell so many trucks? Do you see the naked woman on the top of the moth, placed over the mouth of Jodie Foster? The image has been blown up to view. Not even our children are off limits to this perversion. Do you see the naked lady in the window in this kid's cartoon, The Rescuers? A simple pack of Skittles is now exploding with sex, and Hannah's sweet and sour gummies look just a little bit too yummy. Xbox has never been so sexy. Pepsi knows sex sells even soft drinks. Get all you can all you get has a new meaning. A close-up look of the ice shows the true hidden image. Do you see the girl? This advertisement went as far as airbrushing in the similitude of a male sex organ on her back. A close-up look allows you to clearly see the man's left-hand grip. This ad sold a lot of cigarettes. This message does not need explanation. All of these subliminal images are cleverly designed to greatly influence your behavior and what you look at and what you wear to what kind of car you may drive. Quality control. Now, with that being said and hopefully understood, this brings me back around to Bishop T.D. Jakes' October 2010, 2011, and 2012 Women Thou Art Loose tickets. This man has the funk of 30,000 years and has joined the world in his usage of hidden subliminal sexual images, not once, not twice, but three consecutive times. And his 2010, 2011, and 2012 tickets, all sold for the month of October, tells it all. Once again, pay close attention to the 2010 Women Thou Art Loose ticket, sold for the month of October. Do you see anything out of place? Do you see the similitude of the Baphomet goat with his tongue inside the mouth of a black woman to the far left of the page? Notice the animal-like profile of the sunflower and a slit eye of a goat. Notice protruding tongue into black woman's mouth. Notice the black woman's ethnic profile. Notice the black woman's broad nose and white short afro. Notice the sunflower gripping her face. Notice the black woman's hand gently holds on to the hand of the sunflower. You can almost see fingers. Notice the sunshades that the black woman is wearing. There is even a small sun reflector in the right lens. Notice that her head tilts upward, receiving her tongue kiss, while the sunflower head is tilted downward, with it sticking its tongue into the black woman's mouth. Notice who looks like they're in control of the relationship and kiss, the Baphomet. By enlarging the picture, you can now see that the tongue has a slight pink tone to it. Notice the prominent lower lip of the Baphomet goat. Notice how the black woman is sucking on the goat's tongue. Notice how this sunflower is cupping the black woman's face with both hands. He even has a finger under the black woman's chin to lift her head high to him. The black woman looks totally enamored and greatly seduced. This is what you're looking at. Right here, you can see his eye. I put a circle here so you can see his eye. His eye is right there. And so I put this goat eye here so you can see what a goat eye looks like. It's not like, you know, a round pupil or anything. It has like a little slit there. And if you look, I put this circle here so you can see that it's right there. You can see his tongue. You can see her face, her shave, her little white afro. And I found this picture here on the internet to give you an idea of what you're looking at right here. And this is the Baphomet here. All right, this is what this stands for. Thanks, T.D. Jakes. Other names for Satan is Daystar, the shining one, one who spreads light. This is why bright sunflowers were used on the ticket. And this is why sunshades were used on the black woman that was secretly placed on the ticket, sending the message that Satan is too brilliant to look at. This 2010 Woman Thou Art Loose ticket is a dedication to the Prince of Darkness, Satan. T.D. Jakes honoring Satan in the month of October. So where do you think this placed the women at the conference? For we can plainly see where they were placed on the 2010 ticket. Once again, pay close attention to the 2011 ticket. So for the month of October, do you see anything out of place here? Do you see the loose, naked woman with her exposed breast out, with a figure between her legs giving her oral sex? Notice the white woman's exposed breasts. Notice the areola shading of the breast area. Notice the curve of the body on the right side, coming in at the waistline and going back out at the hip. Notice the hips flaring out. Notice the round, orange, simulated head positioned directly over where her genitals would be. Notice her simulated right leg extended to the bottom of the ticket. Notice her simulated right leg extends to the bottom of the ticket. Notice the horizontal position of the white woman that she is laying on her back. Notice the dark shading semicircle between her legs. This is done so you can clearly see that her legs are open. Notice the smile on Bishop T.D. Jakes' face. Woof in sheep's clothing. So this is what you're looking at. I cover this up for this was not necessary. You see her here, her breast here, the shading of her areola. You see the curve of her waistline, the simulated head here. Her legs are open. This is why the dark shading is here, so they want you to see that. But you can clearly see her waistline on both sides and her breasts up here. And he's between her legs, and this is what you're looking at right here. This is what you're looking at. Thanks, T.D. Jakes. Wolf in sheep clothing. I wanted to draw your attention to the large W in the word woman used on the 2010, 2011, and 2012 tickets. The 2011 and the 2012 ticket has a sexy, loosely drawn W in an outline silhouette of a woman's lower body. Here she is standing with her legs apart, with her hips and private area thrust forward, with her left simulated arm extended out as looking for attention, with her right arm giving the image that it is resting on the right hip, all signaling a loose woman. But pay close attention to the W in the 2010 ticket. The sketch drawing of the W simulates blood. The W is made to look like it is written in blood. So why is this? Remember, on this 2010 ticket is where the Baphomet goat is honored. Here he has his tongue inside the mouth of a black woman. A covert announcement written in blood to black women in the month of October is nothing good. I peeped the itinerary of the 2013 Woman Thou Art Loose conference, this time held in the month of August. Apostasy, apostasy, apostasy. On day two, Oprah's life class lessons were being taught to the women at the conference, okayed by Bishop T.D. Jakes himself. This is the same Oprah Winfrey that denies Christ as being the only way to Yah. The same Oprah Winfrey that follows the teachings of Eckhart Tolle, a New Age guru. The same Oprah Winfrey that said Jesus could not possibly be the only way is now teaching the women of the conference. Trick or treat, ladies. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doeth he meditate day and night. Looks like T.D. Jakes don't care too much for Psalms 1. The ladies were given a 3-day stay with the bishop. Day 1, a little preaching. Day 2, a little teaching. And day 3, the bishop sends the women off with a little something-something. The ladies were presented with a Saturday night concert, the Woman of Purpose concert. For this purpose was the Son of God manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Having begun in the spirit, are ye now made perfect by the flesh? Special guest, Jennifer Hudson. Mary, Mary. Babyface. Brandy. Tamar Braxton. Steve Harvey. Joe, yes, I want to know what turns you on, Joe. These and more serenaded the women throughout the night, comedy included. Bishop T.D. Jakes has absolutely no shame in his game, deceiving black silly women who love to have his soul. Ye adulterers and adulteresses, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with God? Whosoever, therefore, will be a friend of the world is the enemy of God. Need I say more? Scheming silly women is big business. Ladies, Yahshua has clearly told us in his word, through covetousness shall greedy preachers with fringe words make merchandise of you. Ching, ching. A whole group of you are being taken to the cleaners. How many offerings, how many books, CDs, videos, and early registrations for a fee were crammed down your throat? You do the math. It's your checkbook. Yahshua has cruelly told us in his word that in the last days, men will be lovers of pleasures more than lovers of Yah. He has clearly told us in his word that it is this sort of person that creeps into houses and lead captive silly women laden with sins, led away with divers lusts, ever learning and never able come to the knowledge of the truth. Yahshua has clearly told us in his word, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up your cross and follow me. Yahshua has clearly told us in his word to seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Seeking the kingdom takes a lifetime. He has clearly told us in his word to preach the word, to be instant in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers, preachers, having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth. Preachers like Bishop T.D. Jakes, Dr. Cindy Tram, and more. He has clearly told us in his word there shall be mockers in the last days who shall walk after their own ungodly lusts. These be they who separate themselves, sensual, having not the spirit. So maybe this is why Bishop T.D. Jakes joked about a porn site to the women with them laughing their heads off.
You to do one thing you're doing in that call letters for Facebook, what they need to know to get on. They may already know it, but I'm a computer illiterate, and there's probably somebody else like me. Amen. And you be to send them to a porn site because you don't know what you're doing. They be looking at all kind of stuff. You come back there all confused. Put them letters up at children so they can see.
Itching ear preachers tell you what you want to hear. Bishop T.D. Jakes has your approval because you're silly. You're silly for not obeying the word of God. Silly women that are laden in sins and carried away with many lusts draw flies like Bishop T.D. Jakes. Satan himself can transform into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. Yahshua said, "He that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber." Bishop T.D. Jakes is coming through the back door using sexual subliminal images on his "Woman, Thou Art Loose" tickets. This makes him a pervert, a thief, and a robber. This is a little detour, but not off the subject matter, but urgently need to be said. To all parents that love their children, please pay close attention to the poster advertisement for Mega Kids, hosted by Bishop T.D. Jakes at Mega Fest. Please notice that the writing starts off in a pretty hot pink. Notice the slanted K in the middle of the word Mega Kids. The K upside down looks like a perfect Y, which was spelled gay, in the middle of the word Mega Kids. It would now read, "Me gay kids." Oprah Winfrey supports gay rights, and T.D. Jakes supports Oprah. MegaFest is infested with mega flies, Beelzebub, Lord of Flies. Parents, protect your children from this wolf that's trying to pervert them. Back to our subject. These Women Thou Art Loose conferences are designed to breed loose, rebellious, and Jezebel women in the earth. Your silliness guided you to the conference, and your obedience to God's word will keep you from future conferences. Bishop T.D. Jakes sells tickets with subliminal sexual images to the women. Afterwards, when they are seated, he sells them his Women Thou Art Loose Bible for a fee of $30. He says the $30 was not for the Bible book, but for the 800 days he spent on writing the Bible book. So that meant it was for the Bible book. The title, "The Holy Bible Woman Thou Art Loose Book." I thought we were not supposed to sell the Word of God or add to it. Ladies, why would you want to buy this diabolical Bible that has a woman placed on it, sitting on her butt to the side with a black bra and black underwear on, with right arm and elbow reaching up, covering her profile, with a snake's head peeping out at the right lower side of the waistline, with a snake's tail wrapping across her lower back area, with a split tongue placed on the tip of the tail, woman outlined in white for location? And ladies, I hate to say this, but I must. It looks like she's leaning into someone taking care of an oral situation. It looks like it's more than just one head on the front cover of this diabolical Bible. $30, please. He feeds you slop, and you happily pay for it. T.D. Jakes is leading many into hell, and many going to hell follow T.D. Jakes. Yahshua loosed a woman that was bent double by a demon for free. He even paid taxes for Peter and himself when tax time came around for free. He fed multitudes, men, women, and children over and over, and never once took up one offering from the people. He had time to eat, drink, and hang out with common folk like me. Yahshua said to his disciples, "Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely you have received, freely you give." So why does Bishop T.D. Jakes sell his demonic Woman Thou Art Loose unholy Bible for $30? Because you are his merchandise that worship and adore this wolf. He tells you what you want to hear. Therefore, you hear what he tells you. Time would fail me twice if I were to give insight to all of Bishop T.D. Jakes and Dr. Cindy Trim's demonic antics on this conference, the subliminal sexual images, and the smooth, velvety voices of Joe and Babyface should have put the final nail in the coffin for most. But here are some more highlights of Dr. Cindy Trim's game. Bus countdown. Dr. Cindy Trim is a master at speaking very rapidly with the intent of dropping blasphemous teachings about Christ, then quickly moving on to another subject. Bus number one. During her message, Dr. Cindy Trim began to quote the Lord's Prayer, and she quoted it like this: "Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Here is the video.
Even as Jesus had prayed or taught his disciples to pray, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, then hallowed be thy name, then hallowed be thy name, then hallowed be thy name.
Still not convinced? There's more. Bus number two. Dr. Cindy Trim tells the women to go back to their communities and get involved in some type of issues, such as human trafficking, drug abuse, domestic violence, gang violence, immigration issues, education issues, health issues. She said, pick an issue, any issue. She then flashed a 666 sign. She then told the women to let yourself be distinguished among the great and mighty. She then flashed a Baphomet sign, letting us know who the great and mighty is. People, wake up to Cindy. Here is the video.
In me, I'm now expressing it through a business, a book, a song, through something in the community, each one of you. The issues are overwhelming, and there is enough for each one of us to do. Before you walk out of here, pick an issue, any issue. It doesn't matter what. Any issue. Human trafficking, drug abuse, domestic violence, gang violence, immigration issues, education issues, health issues. Pick an issue, any issue. Ask God, place the anointing of Deborah upon me and let me distinguish myself amongst the great and mighty.
Still not convinced? There's more. Bus number three. Dr. Cindy Trim was telling the women about October and the Jewish and Christian calendar. She then quickly quoted Aleister Crowley, a notorious Satanist's favorite quote. Aleister Crowley was an heroin addict, bisexual, and a Satan worshiper who asked people to call him the Beast, 666. He was known as the most wicked man alive. As above, so beneath was one of Crowley's favorite quotes, and now we hear Dr. Cindy Trim quoting it too, being demonstrated by the Baphomet goat. Also demonstrated by Lady Gaga, as above, so below. Here is the video.
Jewish calendar and the Christian calendar have now been placed in sync, as above, so beneath.
Still not convinced? There's more. Dr. Cindy Trim just completed making the women very happy when she decided to once again slip through the back door. Bus number four. Dr. Cindy Trim boldly said, you know, spiritual warfare is the counsel of the human mind by any other spirit other than the spirit of the Lord, and quickly changed the subject. Here is the video.
So, spiritual warfare is the counsel of the human mind by any other spirit other than the spirit of the Lord. In other words,
did you see how quick, fast, and in a hurry she dropped the subject and moved on? This is straight out witchcraft right before everyone's eyes. Dr. Cindy Trim is deceitfully saying that the Holy Spirit cannot counsel you, but any other spirit can. Not only is she blaspheming against the Holy Ghost, but she is also trapping the women under a vicious curse. But this is the same woman that said Yahshua walked on frozen water. The Bible says Yahshua was full of the Holy Ghost from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being there 40 days, being tempted of the devil. The Bible says when the Spirit of truth has come, he will guide you into all truth, for he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. It is through the Holy Ghost and only through the Holy Spirit of the Lord do we have any understanding and counsel concerning the things of Yahweh and the spirit world. Dr. Cindy Trim is a liar and a thief like her father, Satan, and don't want you connected with real power, Holy Ghost power. Still not convinced? There's more. Bus number five. She said, take your Louis Vuitton money and your Gucci money, and abruptly said, it's a miracle, and then flashed a Baphomet sign, the devil's horns. Here's the video.
Man, please come. Please come, I release you to give. Dr. Trim, I wish God wasn't talking to me, but he's talking to me. Take your Louis Vuitton money and your Gucci money. It's a miracle, I'm serious. I have a problem with church folk.
So why did Dr. Cindy Trim abruptly voice out a statement that made absolutely no sense? I'll tell you why. Dr. Cindy Trim is boldly playing mind games, which is another form of witchcraft. This she did to the women of the conference. She voiced out a distraction, creating immediate attention on herself. And when she got it, she raised high her hand and threw up the Baphomet sign for all to see. Dr. Cindy Trim is bewitching you. She is shucking your mind with nonsense. Remember, in my last video, she boldly spoke on shucking the minds of the saints. She says she does this so that a person won't have time to think. This is straight out witchcraft. Every time Dr. Cindy Trim throws up the Baphomet sign in a church, conference, summit, or whatever, she is opening up an invitation and creating a doorway, a portal, for demons to enter into a church service, loosen legions of demonic spirits on the church. This is the reason why she repeats this demonic hand gesture numerous times throughout her teachings. Bus number 6. Yeshua ate and hung around common folk his entire ministry and taught his disciples to do the same. But Dr. Cindy Trim told the women, I remove you from the common into the extraordinary, decreeing and declaring all the women of the conference millionaires and billionaires with mortgage-free mansions. I guess Dr. Cindy Trim didn't get a chance to read, but he that is greatest among you shall be your servant, and whosoever shall exalt himself shall be abased, and he that shall humble himself shall be exalted. Bus number 7. It came time for offering. Dr. Cindy Trim spoke to everyone about giving. She said, you're not giving to a minister, but you're giving to a rim. Absolutely no Bible to support such rubbish, but the women listened and gave. She then asked those who were viewing her via online to send in their checks or to use their credit cards. She immediately went right into decreeing and declaring mortgage-free mansions on all those who gave. Dr. Cindy Trim openly asked 40 women to give $1,000, 40 to give $500, 400 to give $100. There were thousands left in their seats. These she asked to give $40 each. You do the math. But Yeshua has said, when you give your alms, when you give your offerings, do it in secret, and your heavenly Father, which see in secret, will reward you openly. Yeshua said, when you do it in front of men, you have your reward. In other words, your reward is being seen of men, so don't expect anything from Yahweh. Yeshua said, let not your right hand know what your left hand is doing. Giving is always between you and Yahweh. Dr. Cindy Trim gets paid by deceiving you out of your money. Satan has given her a plot that works on people who do not obey the word of Yah. Remember, whatever you do not yield to Christ, the devil will certainly feed on. Dr. Cindy Trim is a wolf in sheep's clothing that knows what the Bible says about giving, but blatantly do not obey it. Why? For the love of money, your money. Bus number 8. Dr. Cindy Trim told the people that she never has to pray for money because she has a money tree in the spirit realm. And I'm sure many believed her. Unbelievable. I do have to give Cindy her props. She made sure to tell the women that her money tree was in the spirit realm, just in case somebody asked to see it. Good looking out. The only money tree that Dr. Cindy Trim has is silly church folk. You take away the silly church folk, you take away her money tree. Bus number 9. Dr. Cindy Trim told the women that when God brings you to the church, he brings you to the church to turn your genius on, to turn your intellect on. Dr. Cindy Trim said, he washed away your sins. He didn't wash away your intellect, and he didn't wash away your brain. The women all screamed and rejoiced to know that God didn't wash away their brains, their intellect, or their genius from their bodies. Now, how silly is this? Here is the video.
And when God brings you to the church, he brings you to the church to turn your genius on, to turn your intellect on. He washed away your sins. He didn't wash away your intellect, and he didn't wash away your brain.
No, he didn't wash away your brain. That's your job, your reasonable service. He just can't use your brain until you wash it with the water of his word. Dr. Cindy Trim don't tell you this either. Ladies, the word of Yah tells us, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. Bus number 10. Dr. Cindy Trim tells the women that the best way to get back at your enemies is to be successful. For the first time, the women became very quiet because they knew that this statement was not true. So Dr. Cindy Trim went right into saying things that didn't make any sense to cover her heresy. She then quickly changed the subject to, this is going to be the last day you're going to ask permission to be yourself. When you leave here, you're just going to let it all hang out. This rebellious statement got the women's attention and applause. Here is the video.
That you give them something to talk about. Amen. Give them something to talk about. Let me tell you how you get back at your enemy. This is how you get back at your enemy. Getting back at your enemy only means that you need to be successful. And the way that you get back at your enemy is to be successful. Amen. It's not to run around. It's not to cry. Listen, this is the last day you are going to ask permission to be you. Amen. You're going to leave here and you're just going to let it all hang out. Amen.
First of all, you're not supposed to be getting back at your enemies. That's not your job. And Dr. Cindy Trim knows this. Secondly, the word of Yah have told us, dearly beloved, avenge not yourself, but rather give place unto wrath. For it is written, vengeance is mine and I will repay, saith the Lord. Bus number 11, Dr. Cindy Trim told the women that your seed, your money, is your power. She then misconstrued the word of God and said to the women, the Bible says he gave them power. So Yahshua gave his disciples money? Your money is not your power. Ladies, the word says you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you. It didn't say you will receive money and riches, but Holy Ghost power. The word of Yah tells us, labor not to be rich and cease from your own wisdom. You might want to tell Dr. Cindy Trim this. Bus number 12. Dr. Cindy Trim said, 4 is the number of the earth. She said, one of the reasons why God brought man to the earth is to replicate and duplicate himself in the earth realm, as I live in dominion. She then said, when men fell, they fell from a realm of dominion.
Was the fourth judge very significant? 4 is the number of the earth. One of the reasons why God brought man to earth is to replicate and duplicate himself in the earth realm as they live in dominion. When man fell, they fell from a realm of dominion.
First of all, the number 4 is not the number of the earth. Who says, Dr. Cindy Trim or the Word? Secondly, Yahweh did not bring man to the earth, but he made man from the dust of the earth. And Dr. Cindy Trim knows this also, but loved deceiving black silly women. Dr. Cindy Trim said covertly, "As I live in dominion." So who is she referring to? None other than Satan himself. Once again, she immediately covered her heresy by stating, "When men fell, they fell from a rim of dominion." Bus number 13. Dr. Cindy Trim told the women, "We all understand that man was created first." She said, "I don't have problems with being second. Why? Because we all know that the second edition of anything is always better than the first." The women went silly and wild. The very thought of being better than their men, their husbands, put many on their club feet, rejoicing in man's defeat. Here is the video.
"We all understand that the man was created first. I don't have problems with being second. Why? Because we all know that the second edition of anything is always better than the first." Glory to God. Hallelujah.
First of all, no, we don't know the second edition of anything is always better than the first. No, we don't know that. Now, what we do know is the second edition of anything will never outrank the word of Yah. Ladies, as we are not above Christ, so are we not above our men, our own husbands. The head of every man is Christ, and the head of every woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. Dr. Cindy Trim knows this, and marvel that you don't. In closing, Dr. Cindy Trim tells the women, "Something's going to be activated in you," and then flashes the 666 sign. She then says, "Give me about 10 more minutes, and then we're going to seal this thing with a prayer." She then flashes the 666 sign again. Dr. Cindy Trim begins to tell the women to go back to their communities and become a change agent. A change agent is a term used and associated with the New World Order, and Dr. Cindy Trim is very much aware of this. Here is the video.
"Did you hear that after you're loose to go back to your community with your anointing and mantle and become a change agent? Yes, God is getting ready to set it off. Bishop said it.
Dr. Cindy Trim told the women when they get home to involve themselves in one of the following: human trafficking, drug abuse, domestic violence, gang violence, immigration issues, education issues, health issues, all worthy issues, but also a rebellious deterrent from seeking the kingdom of Yahweh. Never at any time did Dr. Cindy Trim tell the women to seek first the kingdom of Yahweh and his righteousness, and all these other things will be added to you. The most obvious thing to be said was never once said, and this is done on purpose. Instead, she sent them on a wild goose chase of issues. She sent them seeking every worldly occupation possible, seeking everything but the kingdom of Yahweh. Yahweh knows what we have need of before you ask, ladies. But he has told us to seek his kingdom first, not issues, and everything else will be added unto us. We are not to seek money, but the kingdom of Yahweh. Dr. Cindy Trim seeks money, your money. Dr. Cindy Trim told the women that God is going to brand you. She had the women repeat, "I am my own brand." She says, so that means you don't have to drop names or take on someone else's personality. She then said, you're going to be the fake. They're going to be the real thing. They're going to make all the money. Nobody wants to be a lookalike. Ladies, Dr. Cindy Trim just openly called you a fake and basically poor, and you applaud her for this information. Now do you see why the Bible calls you silly women? Here is the video.
You're going to be the fake. They're going to be the real thing. They'll make the money. Nobody wants a lookalike. Be yourself.
Dr. Cindy Trim is laughing all the way to the bank, and she thinks you ladies are completely rebellious, bewitched, and most of all, stupid. So Dr. Cindy Trim tells you that God is going to brand you, that you are a brand called me, that you do not want to be a copycat of no one, that you don't need permission from anyone, and that you are your own genius. Ladies, are you aware of how arrogant, high-minded, haughty, rebellious, paganish, ignorant, and against the knowledge of Yah this statement is? In the book of Isaiah, chapter 3, verse 24, part of the daughters of Zion's judgment was to be branded by her enemy. And now we hear Dr. Cindy Trim telling the ladies that God is going to brand you. And we know that it is not Yahshua that she is speaking of because he has told us differently. First of all, you're not a brand called me. You're a child of the Most High God. Me has been bought for a high price a long time ago. You're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people that should show forth the praises of him who have called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. She desires that you copy no one. Once again, she is omitting the obvious of whom to copy and just say, don't copy anyone. But she doesn't tell you to copy Yahshua, not even once. For something to be so obvious, she constantly neglects to do it. Ladies, Yahshua has told us in his word, I and my Father are one. When you see me, you see the Father. Yahshua was not only a copycat of his Father, but he was also the express image of his person. Remember, when you copycat Yahshua, you copycat all power, who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person and upholding all things by the word of his power. The Bible tells us to let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God thought it not robbery to be equal with God. Dr. Cindy Trim did not tell you and won't tell you, but you are to copycat the Christ, Yahshua, our soon coming King. Dr. Cindy Trim continues to work her magic and tells the women that they don't need permission from anyone. This ignorant statement is completely exalted against the knowledge of Yah. Yes, you do need permission for various things. If you're married, you need permission from your husband. And to all the rest, Yahweh has said, in all your ways, acknowledge me, and I will direct your path. Yes, you need permission. Ladies, the Bible says, submit yourself one to another, and wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Yes, you need permission. Ladies, did you hear that? So let the wives be subject to their own husbands in everything. Now, for some women, this is a hard saying and can be quite offending to them. But Yahshua has said, blessed is he who's not offended in me. Have the Lord in great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices, as in obeying the voice of the Lord. Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hearken than the fat of rams. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry. Dr. Cindy Trim said to the women that they are their own genius. Here we have another ignorant statement completely exalted against the knowledge of God spoken by Dr. Cindy Trim. Now, you are your own genius. So this means you are your own intellect. You are your own boss. You are your own little God. After all, the word genie comes from the word genius. With no Bible, chapter, or verse, Dr. Cindy Trim has managed to slip you into darkness by placing you into a name brand bottle called Me, giving all the women promotions to genius status, making you all smart enough to be self-contained and independent from all. You have been seduced to become your own little genie in a name brand bottle called Me. So all she has to do now is rub you the right way to get all her wishes and dreams come true. Like Eve, she too was promised a little god status by the serpent, desiring to be wise and a genius too. The idea of being wise over one's head is still an age temptation for many women today. The word of Yah tells us, do you see a man wise in his own eyes? There is more hope for a fool than him. Do know the wisdom of this world is foolishness with Yahweh, so don't be tempted with the old age desire to be a little god, one to be wise. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and I will bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent. Your speech, your life should not be with enticing words of man's wisdom, man's intellect, man's genius, but in demonstration of the spirit and power, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God, as daughters of Sarah. That no flesh should glory in his presence, and that would include Dr. Cindy Trim's You Are Your Own Genius, heretic teachings, fleshly exalted against the knowledge of Yah and demonically induced. Ladies, hell is going to have a special chamber called Silly Women for rebellious, high-minded, and arrogant women that rebel against their heads, which is their husbands. Your pastor might not agree with this, but the word of Yah does. Ladies, so much for Dr. Cindy Trim's Burger King doctrine, having it your way. Your brand called me is supposed to be dead and buried, and your life that you now live is supposed to be hidden in Christ. Yahshua is the true vine, and his father is the farmer. That means we're in good hands with all power. So you should be abiding in the vine as a branch and not a brand. Satan was said in his heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. There is nothing new under the sun, and what has been done will be done again. I will be like the Most High. I will be like my own genius. Dr. Cindy Trim and Bishop T.D. Jakes is knocking at the back door, and consciously, now you know. Trick or treat, ladies. Yahshua love you. Be blessed.